And quantum mechanics provides a notion of random events, that there are events in the universe that are inherently random, and we could count things like radioactive decay with a Geiger counter and use that to generate randomness from physical events. Thermal noise is an easier thing to measure in most circumstances. If you can measure that precisely enough, it also depends on quantum mechanics at some level and produces a randomness. And many modern processors have ways of generating a small amount of randomness by measuring thermal noise in the processor. Whether it's really physically random depends on a lot of other things. You can also look at things that actually happen and think that they're random. Maybe if they're key presses or user actions, maybe those are random. An example of this is when we generate a new key using GPG. It will ask you to generate, when you start to generate a key, it says we need lots of random bytes. And you can perform some type of action, like moving the mouse using the disk, to help generate more randomness for it. And humans aren't good at doing random stuff. When we move the mouse, we're probably moving it in a pattern. When we type on the keyboard, maybe we're doing things that are not very random. So unless you're generating your randomness from quantum physics, there's always some question whether it's really random enough or whether you could predict the particular motions I took. And certainly, given that this has been recorded and released, the fake key that I generated for Alyssa B. Hacker should not be used for any secure purpose. So this approach of waiting for physically random events is okay for GPG, maybe, because someone using it is probably patient enough to be willing to sit around for a while doing random stuff as well as a human can to generate a key. This would not work very well when you need more randomness more quickly. And this happens every time you do a web transaction. Every time someone does a secure web session, anytime you see the lock key in your browser, there's a protocol going on called TLS. We'll talk about that more in a later unit. But one thing that that requires is a new random key for each secure web session. I don't think many people would tolerate being asked to move around their mouse and do strange things to generate enough randomness in the hopes that that key is secure every time you connect to a website. So we need something better. We need a way to take a little bit of physical randomness, and that's usually known as the seed. That's the initial state, and that's the input to what's known as a pseudo-random number generator. And that produces a long sequence, this longer than the amount of physical randomness we started with, of random bits. So that's our goal, to take a small amount of physical randomness, some source of entropy that we can use as a seed, have some function that will compute from that seed a long sequence of apparently random bits.